Powerhouse, presented by Alliant Energy.
Alliant Energy, we're on for you.
Welcome back to Powerhouse. Hey, we all love a night out at the movies. Who doesn't? But a lot of families these days are deciding to forego the hassles of crowds and ticket lines and babysitters and install their own in-home theater system. With all the technology that's out today, like HDTV, digital sound, it's possible to install a home theater system that rivals the best cinema in town. And of course, your audio and video equipment that you select are important, but let's not forget the lighting. Here to tell us about how to achieve the appropriate and ideal in-home theater lighting is Mark Dubit from DB Acoustics. And Mark, what's the big secret about theater lighting?
Well, theater lighting, you know, we're trying to create a certain ambience and a certain look in this room. And to do that, we use the audio and video, but we're also playing a role with the lighting. And the lighting has to be a controlled environment.
Okay, so how do we begin the process?
We would start with a homeowner from a construction stage. From their blueprint, they would come in and talk to us, and we would help them with placement of lighting as well as seating, you know, to create that environment. And we'll also work with a dimming control system so that we get the right balance that we want.
Okay, what kind of lighting is available to us?
Well, in this case, this room has elevated seating, so we have some safety issues that we're concerned with. And we're going to use actually a toe kick lighting that's custom built in so that we have lighting so no one trips as they go up to the second level of seating. We also have some sconce lighting involved, which is more of an ambience type lighting. We have some down can lighting that's up on the ceiling over the seating area. If they want to use a remote control or look through a TV guide, they have the ability to turn those lights on and be able to do that. We also have some lighting up here that's built into the cabinetry and more of an accent type lighting. When you go to a commercial cinema, there's always some lighting up here along the screen. They want to keep the light up a little bit while you're watching a movie. If we go to a dark scene, you know, we're not doing eye fatigue. We also, in this room, have some lighting that's involved over our equipment in case you want to add a DVD or change a DVD.
You think of everything.
We try to, you know. We try to do that, and we also automate that then through a control system. Using keypad type controls, and there's a variety of them here on the counter. If we got into a room that was a multi-purpose room that might have exterior lighting, you know, from natural lighting coming in through windows, we do shades and shade automation systems where we have different fabrics and different materials of different percents of openness so that we can take the sun totally away or we can let a percent of it in, you know, from a 1% all the way up to a 10% openness factor in our shade material.
So people with windows shouldn't be deterred from installing a home theater system.
No, not
that
at all.
That problem can be alleviated.
Yeah, not at all. And these are a silent motor, so you really, you know, you can drop them down while you're watching the movie and not have to worry about the whine or howl of a motor.
Oh, that's a great feature. Now let's talk a little bit more in depth about the controls. People may be intimidated once they get all of these things installed. How do I run them?
Mm-hmm. Very, very simple. And in this room, I'll walk over here. In this room, we're actually using a Lutron Graphic Eye product. These are the actual dimming controls that are being used in this space. And we have the ability to adjust our lighting levels on the little small buttons here. This would then be closed and put into a memory. Then we would activate either from the buttons on the front panels, or we have a keypad in this case, or what I like to use in this case, I'm the lazy guy. I like to use scene control off of my remote control, where I actually dim and do the automation from different lighting scenes that I've programmed.
So you can sit in the comfort of your beautiful theater chairs, which we have in here. Is this something that I, as a do-it-yourselfer, can do if I feel a little handy?
Well, we would say you could do portions of it. Want to limit it to the fact that this is high voltage wiring. So, you know, you do have some shock issues involved with that. But as far as, you know, having some input and layout in detail, you certainly can have some involvement there. I would really suggest maybe they want to be able to do their own programming on the dimmer control panel. They can certainly play with that and set the scenes up. But from a placement standpoint of where we put the light loads and all of that, it's really critical to get those right the first time. You know, so you're not opening drywall after the fact and moving a light.
Troubleshooting.
That's correct.
Afterward. Well, looking around and seeing this home theater, your artistry and obviously your experience behind it is remarkable.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mark. Stay with us. We'll be back with more Powerhouse.